تفضل.
These protests. The women were marching, the children carrying olive branches. Nobody at that point was asking for you to step down. It has escalated. Do you think that your forces cracked down too hard?
They are not my forces. They are military forces belong to the government.
Okay, but you're the
government.
I don't
own them. I'm president. Okay. I don't own the country. So they're not
No,
my
but
forces.
You have to give the order.
No. We have in the constitution, in the law, the mission of the institution to protect the people, to stand against any chaos or any terrorist. But their job, according to the constitution and to the law of the institution.
The crackdown was without your permission?
What do you mean by crackdown?
The reaction to the people, the some of the murders, some of the things that happened.
No, there's a difference between having policy to crack down and between having some mistakes committed by some officials. There's a big difference. For example, when you talk about policy, it's like what happened in Guantanamo when you have policy of torture, for example. We don't have such a policy to crack down or to torture people. You have mistakes committed by some people, or we have some allegations about mistakes. That's why we have special committee to investigate what happened, and then we can tell according to the evidences you have mistakes or not. But as a policy, no, we don't have.
Have there been mistakes made in this crackdown? Yes.
No, self-evidently yes, for one reason, because when you don't prepare yourself for a new situation, you're going to make mistakes.
Okay. Have the people who made the mistakes been found accountable? Have they been punished?
Some of them, yes, according to the evidences. But you cannot punish anyone according to rumors or allegations. So this is judicial committee, independent judicial committee. It's job to detain people if they are guilty and to send them to the court for prosecution.
To the protesters. Do you think that the crackdown in the beginning was too much?
It's about personal mistakes, not about policy. There was no policy of cracking down.
Who made
there was policy of facing the terrorists. When you have militants, you have to face the militants. You don't allow in the United States to have militants. And remember what happened in Los Angeles in the 90s when you sent the army to the city to face the terrorists. Did the same.
In our protests, we don't kill people, and we have press seeing
it. But nobody knows yet who killed the people. Because the same question: who killed the 1,100 soldiers? If you don't know who killed those, you can tell who killed the civilians.
The crackdown in the beginning, the brutality. Do you think it went too far?
I cannot tell you this without the evidence. You ask me to tell you according to rumors or to reports. It's not enough for me as president. For me, when there's policy, I could say yes or no. When there's individuals with concrete evidence who committed mistake, I could say yes or no.
Did you give the order for the crackdown?
No, we give the order to implement the constitution and the law. That's the order, and that's the job of the president.
But who gave the order to react against the protesters?
You don't need order, because this is their job.
Well, somebody had say, you know, use guns. Somebody had to say there are arrests.
No, there was even written not to use guns. That's why I said it wasn't policy. Their job is to prevent people, like any other country. You have their own means. They have these plastic stick things. Whenever they used machine guns against civilians, this is a breaching of the law.
It happened.
In some cases, yes. And they were caught. And they were detained, I mean.
I want to make this clear. You say that the country in general is stable. Certainly, we see here in Damascus, since we've been here, it's business as usual. But there are areas of this country, an hour and a half away, in which there is still fighting, in which there is still protests.
That's right.
Do you see that as something important, people fighting for their freedom, or do you see it as a little something here and a little something there?
No, you have different components. Not everybody's fighting for the freedom. You have people who want freedom, and that's why we have reform, because we recognize those people. And most of the people that they need freedom, they didn't demonstrate. Not everybody in the street demonstrating for freedom. You have different components. You have extremists, religious extremists. You have outlaws, people who have been convicted in the court and they've been escaping for 4 years now, drug smugglers, and you have like-minded people of Al-Qaeda and those. So it's different components. You have money coming from outside just for the media, propaganda. They give money to people, they demonstrate for 15 minutes or for half an hour, then in the media you see demonstration. So you have different components. I'm not saying you have one here. You have everything. You have real demonstrations, you have peaceful demonstration, you have militants, you have terrorists, you have everything. In the same place sometimes.
Mr. President, you have people an hour and a half away from here, yes, protesting. You have people who have been killed and people who have, yes, been tortured, and still they're protesting. And you say you have the support of your people?
No, no. You are mixing between the protesters and the killing. It's different. Now we are having terrorists in many places killing.
Now?
No, not only now. No, from the very beginning. No, not now. Now it's recognized in the media. That's the difference. But from the very first few weeks, we had those terrorists. They are getting more and more aggressive. They've been killing. We have over 1,100 soldiers and policemen killed. Who killed them? Peaceful demonstrations? This is not logical. This is unpolitical.
Our view is there were peaceful protesters. They were killed. Some were tortured. It was a brutal reaction. Mm. Are we wrong in thinking that?
Every brutal reaction was by individual, not by institution. That's what you have to know. Not by institution. Institution means policy. We don't have policy. We don't have institution that kill people or give order for brutal reaction. This is individual, and that's what I call, what I describe as individual mistakes.
But not by your command?
No. We don't have, no one's command. There was no command to kill or to be brutal.
So that was individual people
of course,
individual
definitely
overreacting?
That depends, because when you have chaos in some areas, anyone could make this mistake or committed a crime or aggression or whatever.
Do you think it's the biggest misconception that my country has of what's happening here, if indeed there is a misconception?
Misconception about a lot of things I cannot tell you, because so many facts, distorted facts, you have them in the media. But the most important thing, as accumulation of these facts, you don't have vision. The problem with the West in general, especially the United States, they don't have vision about at least my region. I wouldn't talk about the rest of the world. Failing in Iraq, failing in Afghanistan, failing in fighting terrorism. The situation is getting worse and worse in the rest of the world. The question you ask as American, what did you get? Where did you win? You spend trillions where you could spend a few hundred of millions and get better results. So that it harms your interest, but at the same time, it harms others' interests. So this is the misconception, I think.
Dealing with the protesters, what is the misconception, if there is any,
about the
protests?
Yeah.
That's what is being focused on now.
Okay. We don't kill our people. Nobody kill, no government in the world kill its people unless it's led by crazy person. For me as president, I became president because of the public support. It's impossible for anyone in this state to give order to kill people. We have militants, those militants killing soldiers and killing civilians. This morning we lost 9 civilians killed in Homs, in the middle of Syria, and they are supporters. Most of the victims are government supporters. That's something they don't know. They think every civilian is demonstrator and every civilian is against the government.
Last week, an independent United Nations commission who interviewed more than 225 people issued a report. What it said was that your government committed crimes against humanity. Mm. And they went on torture, rape, and other forms of sexual violence against protesters, including against children. Mm. What do you say to them? I mean, what I'm saying again and again is that protesters were beaten. Things happened to them. Do you acknowledge that? Do you acknowledge what the UN said?
Very simply, I would say, send us the documents and the concrete evidences that you have, and we'll see if that's true or not. You have a lot of allegations now.
Did the UN not send you these documents?
Nothing at all.
You mean the first you're
here? They don't have even the names. Who are the rape people, or who are the tortured people? Who are they? We don't have any name. They didn't.
But they've issued... Mr. President, they have issued this report. They have accused you and your regime.
According to what?
Well, according to what they said, it's 225 people, witnesses, men, women, children, whom they interviewed and identified. And that's when they called it crimes against humanity.
We are government. We have government. We have institutions. They should send us the documents. As long as we don't see the documents and the evidences, we cannot say yes. That's normal. We cannot say just because the United Nations. Who said that the United Nations is a credible institution, first of all?
Who says that the United...
Who said? We know that you have the double standard in the world, in the United States policy, in the United Nations that's controlled by the United States and the West. So it has no credibility. So it's about evidences and documents. Whenever they have, we can discuss it. Just to discuss a report that we don't see any reality related to it. Just a waste of time.
You do not think that the United Nations is a credible organization?
No, for one reason. They haven't implemented, they never implemented any of the resolution that related to the Arab world, for example, to the Palestinians, to the Syrian land. Why don't they? If they talk about human rights, what about the Palestinians suffering in the occupied territory? What about my land and my people that left their land because it's occupied by Israel? Of course not.
You haven't.
For every citizen, it's not for me as president. I'm telling you about the perception in the whole region.
You do not think the United Nations is credible?
It has never been credible.
Really?
Never. It's not something new before my generation. Uh-huh. It's something we inherited as a concept, as belief.
You have an ambassador to the United Nations.
Yeah. It's a game you play. That doesn't mean you believe in it.